Fantastic. Hey, everybody. I am going to do a quick teaching on how to do your own testimony track. Now, years ago, when I first went on the mission field in 2000, I had my own track back then, and it was so misspelled badly that my aunt bought me a dictionary after that. It was really bad, but my heart was right. Amen. So now over the years, 18 years, I've been doing my own track. Instead of people giving me gospel tracts, I like to make my own with my testimony because I have a powerful testimony. And we should all share our testimonies. So this is for those of you that want to do what I have here. And I'm going to go over the whole track with you. Okay? Step by step. What I did. First of all, for many years I had one called Attitude Adjustment. And on the cover it was a picture of my father and me, and it was for a long season of my life, God really wanted me to honor my father and focus on that. But then my father passed away while I was in Thailand, and I just felt like there was a shift, and now this is going to be my new track, okay? So I am also writing a book, or I've already written a book, I just need to edit it. It's called Where Are You Now? And it is my testimony book, and it's going to have lots and lots of details, and it's got the, you know, like 40 states in America here, and then the 64 countries that I've been to, and it's going to have, like I said, way more details. But this is going to be something that I can give people, and I'm going to do it in black and white when I meet them on the streets. And I think it's important that I start doing this again. So what it is it's a brochure, and you can get it off the internet. I use Microsoft Word, okay, so you can see the Word down there. I actually publish books with Microsoft Word. So what this is going to be the front cover, which would be right here, okay? Where are you now? Angela Cummings' testimony. Now, I did not put that I was an evangelist. I did not put something super spiritual with a scripture on the front, a dove. I didn't put a cross. I actually try to steer away from anything hyper, super religious. I'm trying to reach the lost souls with this, not the Christians. So on the back cover, it's going to be my dirty feet here in Indonesia. I thought that was a cool photo. My website here, so when you open it, it'll be here. But on the back, that's what this is, okay? So the very back will be a picture of me standing in front of the White House. I thought, well, a lot of people think that's cool, even overseas. But then I've got the simple gospel right here. In case they never open the track and read anything, boom, most likely they'll turn that over and read that. Well, praise God. That's what we want. Amen. And then on my website, of course, has more scriptures and my testimonies there as well. So when you first open it, it's going to be right here. Okay? That would be this right here. When you first open the tract, that's the first thing they're going to see is baby Angela waving, happy, happy preacher woman, right? Yeah, we want to start the story with your birth. Like, tell a little bit about yourself. So mine says October 27th or 22nd, 1970 is when I was born in Chattanooga, Tennessee, USA, to a 16-year-old mother named Deborah Ann Collins. that named me Kimberly Page Collins and put me up for adoption. The Cummings family adopted me at 3 weeks old. The story begins. Okay, so I'm setting a foundation, letting everybody know I'm adopted. Okay, so a lot of my story, I'm going to pull out key points. One, I'm adopted. Two, I had a name change, and my name was supposed to have to do with my calling. Three, the enemy attacked me my whole life with depression instead of joy. And so, because he possibly knows your calling by your name, okay? So let's go on and make another point. So you see baby Angela, and then you see the happy preacher in Switzerland. And I picked the Swiss picture because that's where I asked God to send me to the nations, was Switzerland. So there I am in Switzerland years later. I've been several times now. Mary Angela Cummings became my new name. It means happy heavenly messenger or happy evangelist. Perfect fit. Amen to that. So here we go. So now you open the track all the way, and here's the rest of the story, okay? So you've got this, page one, page two, and then the final ending, happy ending. Now you are saved, living for Jesus, and going to the nations. Hallelujah. So let's tell the story. Okay, so now that I've showed you how to do the testimony track, for those of you that are still here, welcome. I'm going to read it to you. That way you don't ask me to mail it to you. I'm still going to work on that book that'll have more details. But here is the simple gospel track. This is my testimony. My family already had a debt-free home surrounded by many acres of woods. On the day of my legal adoption, when they came to get me to bring me to their home, my family waited in the lobby while finishing the final paperwork. My 3-year-old adopted brother, Carrie, was jumping up and down, screaming, "Let's bring her home!" He was adopted at birth from another mother in the same city. The caregivers brought me to my family, clothed in white lace dress. My Christian family hoped that they were bringing home a sweet, brown-eyed angel after legal name change. God had a big plan for my life, and Satan feared that plan and attacked my joy. Okay, so then I purposely picked a picture of me happy underneath that on purpose, okay? My mother told me I used to talk with strangers on sidewalks as a child. I was a preacher in training without them even knowing. Also, I walked into Sunday school as a toddler one morning and threw my diaper bag across the room to let everyone know I had arrived. I have always had an attitude about me and still do. My parents told me at a young age I was adopted. My brother accepted his adoption. I struggled my whole life with being adopted. Adopted children either feel chosen or abandoned at birth. Kind of like a glass of water. Is it half full or half empty? I was always saying, I want my real parents, not them. Okay, so I purposely picked a super cool picture of me at Paris, France. Why? Because it seems like everybody wants to go there. So it's just letting people know, hey, been there, done that. I couldn't have gone if it weren't for the grace of God. It's important that people see pictures, not just words. Amen. I chose to focus on the abandonment. Babies can hear in the womb. They can hear the rejection, and their souls get wounded before even being born. My mother could play piano by ear and must have been talented. I may never meet her, but I always have wanted to. My new family took great care of me. They took me to church and taught me about the love of God through Jesus. Very, very important that you don't just say the word God, okay? Because a lot of people think that we all have the same God. Well, no, we don't. So make sure you say the name Jesus throughout your story, okay? My English paper were my honest thoughts on how I was not thankful for anything at Thanksgiving and I wanted to die. My parents were contacted. I ended up in a hospital for almost 4 months getting help from doctors for my depression and death wishes. My parents were trying to save my life. One roommate introduced me to rebellious music and smoking. She committed suicide in her car on a home visit in the garage. I feared all this deep darkness, sin, rebellion, and death around me. I tried to live for Jesus after this season for about 6 months. However, the satanic music I listened to influenced me. I wore rock t-shirts with pentagrams. Meanwhile, I got baptized 3 times in attempts to fight the enemy of my soul. I wanted freedom but did not understand how to follow Jesus. My adoption issues were not fixed with those baptisms, nor was my depression. And you know what I notice here? I need to add that I was 14. Okay, so I'm going to go back and say I was 14. God allowed me to have my free will. Free will is a gift from God, and no one can complain about it at the judgment seat. You and I can choose. Okay, now go over here. So I don't have any photos here because I'm bringing it in for the salvation part, okay? My free will caused me to become an alcoholic, crack cocaine addict, and even a teen mom at 19 by a 30-year-old, twice divorced man with 4 children already. He also hit me and said, I love you, and called me a whore. What a mess I had made with my life after sitting in church 18 years. I was just trying to cover my pain and have some fun without God's rules. Hashtag prodigal. Come home, prodigal. I'm already wanting to preach to this person, aren't you? Come home, prodigal. Get out of that pig pen. After hating my addiction so much that I could not take the extra pain. Notice I said extra pain. I already had pain, but now my addictions cause me extra pain anymore. I crawled on my knees by my father's chair where, is that how you spell it? Where he read his Holy Bible. At 3 a.m., I cried to God for help as I pulled my own hair at 23 years old in July 1994. I went to rehab and was kicked out for cursings. July 31st, 1994 was my last crack cocaine rock. Yay, Jesus! I went to AA for 2 years after this. Soon, I had become addicted to cleaning and started a cleaning business called Compulsive Cleaning. I ran that business 16 years in Tennessee, then Florida, and then Texas. It even made the news a few times. The kindness of God led me to repentance. At 25 years old, I was ready to surrender all to Jesus. I repented of my sins to Him. This is the night I truly was born again, John 3:3. I did not get saved in a church, but at a Christian rock concert after I won free tickets. Jeff Moore. Why should the devil have all the good music? That was one of his songs that night that actually caused me to want to be a Christian. I kid you not, God is good. It's funny. I'm so thankful I didn't get saved in a church, too. God knew I did not want to get saved in a church. God healed my adoption issues one day with Psalms 139. His word is powerful. Then God gave me a vision during church of my birth mother handing me to Jesus. He held me and said, "My little evangelist." I began preaching May 2001 and have now been to 64 countries sharing my story of Jesus being my personal hero. Forgiveness is wonderful in having God's righteousness. Now, I put that because I'm not trying to establish my own righteousness. I got my righteousness from God. Amen. I choose. People need to understand that. I choose to follow Jesus because He's wonderful. Jesus made me, Jesus made me a happy evangelist. Also, my God gave me thankfulness for my family and adoption. Very important to honor your parents at the end of this. Okay, God bless you. I hope some of you will do a testimony tract now and pass them out in your city. God bless.